A lot of people are having difficulty with Chapter 9 problem set number 4, welfare effects of restricting trade through tariffs. So I thought I would go through this with you and guide you along. Suppose Colombia is a small country in the world market for soybeans. The following graph shows the demand and supply curves for the Colombian domestic market for soybeans. The world price is $250 per ton of soybeans. Throughout the question, assume that changes in trade policies in other countries do not significantly affect the world market for soybeans and that there are no transportation or transaction costs associated with international trade in soybeans. Also, assume that domestic suppliers will satisfy domestic demand as much as possible before any exporting or importing takes place. Now, suppose Colombia allows free trade in the market for soybeans. Colombia will import the difference between the demand curve at the world price and the supply curve at the world price. So the difference between, this looks like between 480 and 600 is going to be, looks like 540 minus 60. So that should be 480,000 tons of soybeans. On the following graph, use the green triangle symbols to shade the area representing consumer surplus, CS, and free trade equilibrium. Then use the purple triangle diamond symbols to shade the area representing producer surplus and free trade equilibrium. So I'll take the consumer surplus green triangle and I'm going to have it bounded by the world price and the demand curve. That is my consumer surplus. The producer surplus will be bound by the supply curve and the world price. And that should be my, graphically, the way the consumer surplus and the producer surplus looks. Suppose the Colombian government decides to impose a tariff of $50 on each ton of soybeans. With the tariff, the domestic price of a ton of soybeans will be, from the pull-down menu here, and I think about it, I say, okay, $50 more than the world price, which is $250, so it would be up at $300. And Colombia at $300, it hits the supply curve at $120, it hits the demand curve at $480, so the difference between $480 and $120 is $360, so 360,000 tons of soybeans. Show the effects of the $50 tariff on the following graph. In particular, use the green triangle symbols to show the consumer surplus with the tariff, the purple triangle diamond symbols to show the producer surplus with the tariff, and the red quadrilateral cross symbols to shade the area representing government revenue received from the tariff. Finally, use the tan triangle dash symbols to shade the areas representing deadweight loss, DWL, caused by the tariff. Hint: hover your mouse over any area you shaded to display its value in thousands of dollars. So with a $50 tariff, my consumer surplus will only go down to $300 now instead of down to $250. My producer surplus would be bound in that area of the price and the with the tariff and the supply curve. The government revenue will be the area right in here that I'm highlighting red between the tariff and the world price now. The deadweight loss will be in two different areas, and this is the tan triangles to the left and to the right of the tariff. Summarize your results from the two graphs by selecting the appropriate values in the following table. So we've got with free trade and consumer surplus. With free trade, our consumer surplus was, if I mouse over this, it was 121,500. So that goes to there. Our producer surplus back up in the free trade was 1,500. So 1.5 million. And then the consumer surplus with tariff is now 96,000 as I mouse over the green boxes, so 96 million. The producer surplus is an area of 6,000, so that will be 6 million. The government revenue, which was NA before, because there wasn't any, now there is 18,000 in government revenue, which would be 18 million. So according to your analysis, as a result of the tariff, Columbia's consumer surplus, the consumer surplus is decreasing by the difference between 121.5 million and 96 million, which would be 25.5 million. The producer surplus goes from 1.5 to 6 million, so we know that increases by 4.5 million. The government collects $18 million in revenue, and the net welfare effect is a loss of the amount of the deadweight loss. If I mouse over those, it's an area of 1,500 and 1,500, so that would be 3 million. We can grade it now and see that we got all of the areas right, 21 out of 21.